show me the lights or leave me in darkness. You hear that?
Hello? All right, Jay Britton here, back again with an absolute blinder of a video, joined yet again by Gavin Chronicles. This week I'm a little bit worried because we haven't actually got a location, so we're just driving around. Hopefully we'll get a tip off. So yeah, it's not looking good. Oh, hang on, Gav. Got a notification here from Stephen Grimes, very well respected urbexer within the community. We drink, we laugh, we have fun. And as such, you sent me a voicemail. Gav, keep your fanny crossed, and this is a location.
Hiya, Jake. It's Stephen Grimes here. Hope you're well. I've got a location for you. Keep it under your arm. Don't tell anyone else that I'm giving away locations, because we know that we're not supposed to. Anyway, have an absolute blind. I can't wait for the next video. Ciao, Bella. Bye.
Amazing. So, shout out to Stephen Grimes for letting us know where this place is. He sent us the coordinates. Gavin's turned around appropriately. We're going to go there now. When we get in the house, we're going to be testing out some ghost apps that are proven to work. Gavin has also bought a Ouija board, so we're going to connect with the devil when we're in there. Right, so it's a cheeky cottage in the middle of the forest. Hopefully it's a mansion, because that's better clickbait. Straight in, no f***ing about. Gavin, do you reckon someone's living in there? In there? Bit sketchy. I think if you just stay away from there, we'll be sorted. Guys, I will apologise in advance if the content in this video isn't up to its usual classic standard. I caned it last night and subsequently got a bit of a thick head. Looks like someone's moving that thing. Oh! The f*** was that? Someone just jumped on me, Gav. Gav, I think a frog just jumped on me off the roof. I swear to God. It's like f***ing biblical times.
My fat ass is going through
that
window.
Look at them getting through there. Plus, imagine you going on your own. You're so scared of ghouls.
Yeah, you're going first.
There we go.
Sturdy as.
It's got to go all the way up. I don't know why I've left as used to. You're right there, mate. Are you alright? Oh my god, Gavin. That's mental. That's mental. Shall I be helping? There you go. Okay. Why does that look so horrible, Gav? My turn now. Oh yeah. Nice one, Gav. Gavin's little ghastly face is going to be arriving at one of these windows any second now to let the big guy in. Hope a ghost doesn't try and f*** him on the way down and he completely forgets about me.
Hey, bye! Is anyone up in this horse? Let us know now, because we're cropping our trousers, don't ya?
What's that? I asked you to bring a Ouija board.
Well, it's a board, so it doesn't really...
How is that going to detect a ghost?
We'll have to just set it up and see if they can connect four.
So just we put one in, just to start the game?
I think we should put three in, because who can resist connecting four?
So put one in the middle. I'll put this one in just to like spook people.
Yeah, just, yeah, curveball.
Oh.
Oh.
Did anyone see that?
Was that a ghost?
Comment down below if that was a ghost.
Oh!
Double ghost.
It's just annoying though.
Right, sorry.
So we'll do our little explore now, test some apps, and if at the end of the research that we've done here today, there is a connected four, we know the ghosts are real. Gav, what are you doing? This has got to stop. Gav, so you're just going to jump out of me? This is the whole video, are you jumping out? Oh, f***. Gavin. Well, this is just pointless because I can't move now because I'm crippled with fear. Gav? Gav, I think I can hear people outside as well. So this is just intensifying the whole thing. All right, brilliant. So you're going to jump... Oh, my God! Never funny.
Oh, you could do something with that.
That. Oh, I know what to do. Pop telly on.
Okay.
Good episode, that.
I think this is one of your worst ones.
A bit harsh, don't I think? Perfect. Jesus, yet again, making a spooky appearance. I won't have a bad word said about our Lord, but he is f***ing terrifying.
old vacuums.
That's working after all this time.
What are we listening to? Oh yeah, I'll put that on. Sorry. Oh, is that where you came in? Right, so I'm going to test out a couple of these apps that I downloaded, all free and all proven to work, so bear with me. This first one's called the Ghost Detector. Oh. I don't really know if it's detecting or not. I think the beacon indicates when you're getting close to one. Someone in this room. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, this is clicking too much. I'm getting very scared. Oh my God! Right, enough of that, Gav. That was terrifying. Gav? Oh, Gavin, don't do that hiding thing again. Gav?
Every time.
Are you just hidden around that corner?
What?
Oh, Jesus! Why?
Is this the only thing you do?
I've got something mental that we can do, Gav. It's how to summon a ghost. Hang on, are we playing this game? It's called a closet game.
No. Are you sure?
What is it?
And it came from upstairs. Hello? Right, it's called a closet game. And the objective of the game is to summon a demon. All you have to do is step inside a closet,
if you're going in the closet, are you definitely coming out of the closet?
Is this just a way to do a big punchline?
No. So if you're going in the closet, are you coming out to all your friends and family, just coming out of the closet?
Right.
Why am I holding my hands like this?
Concerned citizen. Right, the closet game is simple. You go into a closet in a haunted house, we got one, and you say, show me the light or leave me in darkness. So you're supposed to be able to feel a presence behind you, which is a demon. You then turn the light on, and then the demon goes.
We both go in there. Can you just go in there? Get in there.
I'm a bit scared.
You're always scared. Everyone's starting to notice how scared you are in these
videos. I don't think they are. I think that's a lie. Okay. And we both got to get. You can't have anyone outside. It says here, Gavin cannot stay outside.
Does it?
There, yes.
Okay. This is the gayest thing I've ever done.
This is a bit weird. Right.
Move your big fat ass.
Hang on then.
Right.
Do you know there's a bigger closet over there?
I like it, the small. Right, go. Right. Can you catch this now? This is really weird.
Okay, hang on.
Yeah.
Show me the light or leave me in darkness. Can you hear that?
Yeah, it's just me.
Oh, okay. Show me the light or leave me in darkness. What was that? Gavin, it stinks. Gavin, no. There's a demon. That stinks. Right, we've tried the closet game. And we're going to have to say that it doesn't work. Jesus, that was a frightening bowel movement though, Gav. That smell is ungodly.
Ooh.
Oh, curveball.
We did not see that come in.
So the ghost was playing all along.
Yeah.
So yeah, proof the ghost is real, guys. Time for us to leave. Come on. And I'm going out first because I'm scared to be in here on my own as standard.
Thank you.
Right, thanks very much for watching this far. You must have liked it a little tiny bit, so show some support and click the like button and comment down below if you think Gavin's going to be having nightmares about that for the rest of his life. Obviously subscribe and turn on notification because me and Gavin do this between every 5 minutes and 6 months and you want to stick around for it. And if you're from the Urbex community and you've got a problem with anything myself or Gavin have done inside that building, you can both politely suck his and then my dick. Right, so if you're finding life incredibly boring, here's Jake Britton's top tip. You take chicken mayo and your standard cheeseburger from McDonald's. You remove the bottom of both burgers, then combine. There you have it, guys. Classic Urbex lunch. I call it the biggest mayo.
got a call like from my dog, like 101. Said they killed his only son because of insufficient funds. He was sobbing, he was mobbing, way belligerent and drunk. Talking out his head, philosophy on what.